In this Procreate tutorial, I will show you how to paint this cute girl with a hat on, step by step. If you like my videos, please don't forget to subscribe, and you can access even more tutorials and brush sets at my Patreon page. You can check it out via the link below this video. Now, if you are ready, let's grab our pencils and get started. I've created a square canvas that is 2000 by 2000 pixels, 300 dpi. This is our color palette, and I bundled up all 9 brushes we will use in this tutorial in a single brush set for you. You can download them via the link in the video description for free. These brushes are from my textures and patterns and seamless knitting pattern sets. If you want the full sets, you can also get them on my Gumroad free of charge. Now let's grab textured liner to draw the girl's head. For that, I will select light orange from the palette and set the brush size to around 12%. Let's draw a circle and make it perfect by tapping on the canvas. Now let's try to fill it by dragging the color inside. If it fills a bigger area, you will need to slide to the left without lifting your pencil up from the canvas to adjust the color drop threshold. Now let's create one more layer above the head to draw the hair and also change the color into light yellow. That comes next. First, let's draw an arc that will go from this side slightly down. Then I will draw another one on the opposite side, but this one will be shorter. Let's connect these two lines with a curve. This will be the haircut, and on top it will just follow the shape. So let's draw another arc around the head. We can also make it perfect by waiting a second to make the quick shape tool work. Now let's also fill the shape by dragging the color. Now we can start drawing her face. I'll go to layer 1 and select the color right from here. We will draw a triangle that's a little curvy. So I'm starting from this point, making the first curve for the nose, and 2 more for the lips. Let's connect the invisible area and also fill it. And now I think we can finish the hair on the opposite side. But for that, we need to create one more layer and place it under the head. Let's also pick the color right from the hair. Here I'll add a shape like this. It may go a little upper than the head and then down. Let's finish it here. Also connect it under the head and then drag the color inside it. I think we can add even more hair. This time it'll go from the nose and repeat the shape of the frontal part. I will connect it and then fill. We can also try to add some hairs, but with a lower brush size. Let's set it to 6%. I'll draw a small one here, then another one, and we can do the same on the frontal part of the hair. So let's go here and draw a few lines. They may go at the lower part as well, repeating these curves. Next, I'd like to draw the eyebrow and the eye. Since the girl is blonde, we can make the eyebrow light. So let's keep on using the same color and same brush. Just set the size to around 4%. And also create a new layer above the head, but under the hair. Let's first draw 2 arcs with an angle to each other. And after that, connect them with another arc. Just try not to make it too round. I will adjust it, then close the invisible part and drag the color inside to fill it. Now let's draw the closed eye, and I want to do it on a separate layer. Let's also create it above the head and select dark red orange color at the bottom of the palette. Here I will make the size even lower, like 2%. I will also start with an arc, then draw this way and add a few lashes. Let's try to drag the color inside the shape and fix it quickly. Now we can start shading the face. For that, I'll create a layer under the eye and clip it to the head, so the strokes won't go outside it. Let's also switch to another brush. That will be textured shader. And first I'd like to add the lips, using light red orange color. Let's set the brush size to 4%. And first I will draw the lower lip, that'll go as a line with an angle. Not pressing too much on the pencil to get the texture. Let's paint this triangle. And maybe add some volume on the lower part of it, with circular strokes. This way we will keep the textured edge. Now I will work on the upper lip. First I will draw an oval here, that will be also textured, and then continue it as an arc. Also not pressing too much on the pencil. Maybe we can make this one a little wider. And now the lips are ready. Let's continue working on the face and shade the nose. I will be using the same color and the same brush. Set the size to 6%. And start making the circular strokes on the tip of the nose, until we get this oval. It may go a little down on this part. And after that, we need to switch to red-orange. That is darker. With this color, let's shade the edge. Go a little upper, then lower the size to around 3 or 4%, and make an arc to this side. After we did that, we need to smudge the colors. So let's switch to smudge tool, where we have textured shader selected as well. Here I will set the size to 2 or 3% and start smudging the borders. I think 3% will work better. So here I will make smudging strokes that'll go up first. Then also smudge the borders here between the colors. And also this arc. Let's smudge this tiny area here. That is the cast shadow from the nose. We can still keep some texture, but smudge most of it. Now that we have the dark colors, let's also add some highlight. And for that, I will pick the color from the hair. Let's highlight this area here. This way. Also, it may go along the forehead and transition to the nose. Let's also highlight this area just a tiny bit. After that, we also need to smudge it. Now let's select the smudge tool and blend these highlights, also with circular strokes. We will smudge it only on the nose, but keep it textured on other parts. I'm smudging it here. And now when we have the highlights and shadows, we can draw the nostril. For that, I'll create a new layer above this one, also clip it, and pick the color from the eye. That is the darkest from the face. Also, let's change the brush to textured liner. and set its size to around 3 or 4%. Let's draw a small oval that will have the shape of a nostril. Then paint inside it, and it is located very close to the edge of the nose. Also, I will draw two lines. First one will go to this side. I'm not pressing too much on it. And the other line will go to the opposite side. This way we'll finish determining the shape of the nose. Let's also smudge these lines very carefully, avoiding the nostril. So I'm going to the smudge tool, lowering its size to 2%, and smudging the lines. It will be the darkest shadow. Let's also smudge it to this side. Now the nose can be considered done, and we can add more shadows. First shadow will go under the hair. So let me select orange color and texture shader brush. I'll set the size to 9% and draw along the hair here, adding the shadow. Also, let's add the shadow under the eyebrow. Here we can lower the brush size and draw a tiny line parallel to the eyebrow. Like this. Alright, now let's also add some blush on her cheek. We can keep on using same color, but change the brush to grainy shader. Here, let's set the size to 3% and start making circular strokes. To get the freckles, I will make a couple of strokes that will go on the nose. And this is also done. Before we shade the hair, let's draw the head. So we will have less work on the hair later. We can merge all the layers for the face and then create a new layer above all layers. In the color palette, I will select pink color and also textured liner from brushes. Let's set its size to 18% and draw the first shape for the head. I'll start from the left side and going up. It doesn't have to be perfect here. On top side, I will draw a curvy line. Then continue on the right side and close the shape at the bottom, also with curvy lines. Let's try to fill this shape and then create a new layer under this one. We can use the same color and draw another shape. It will go like this. First arc and then the other one. It needs to cover the hair. Let's connect them. We also need to close the shape at the bottom and then fill. Since we have them, we can add the pattern. Let's start with this one, and we need to create a new layer above it. In the color palette, I will select pink red. And from the brush set, let's select Q. Here the size actually doesn't matter, because the brush is in texturized mode. If you need to change the size, you need to go to grain settings and change the scale. Let's just paint a shape that will cover the head. Then go to transformation and rotate it so it follows the angle. Then let's switch to warp tool and drag these corners inwards. If we just keep it straight, it won't look so natural. We need to add these arcs on the sides. These two points can go inside as well. and after that we can clip the layer. Let's also add a pattern on this part. So we need to create a layer above it and then also clip it. Here I will select light grayish and also change the pattern. Let's use traditional. We can try to rotate the canvas to follow the angle right away. Let's paint a bigger area around this part, so we can apply warp here as well. I will just fix the sides. To make them more round. Now it is perfect. We can also shade these parts. So let's create a layer between these two and it will be clipped right away. I will be using the same color, but change the brush to textured shader. Let's set it to around 12% and just paint carefully on the upper part and also at the bottom. Go a little to the sides and then smudge it quickly. Let's draw this fluffy detail on top of the head. So we can merge these three layers and create a new one above. Let's first select the brush. It will be cartoon fur that we already used in the kitten tutorial. And if you remember, this brush has two colors. We need to select them. So if we go to color disk and tap on the first color, we can pick light grayish. Let's go back and tap on the second color. Here I will select dark pink. Let's set the brush size to 35% and start making circular strokes to one side first and then to the other one. Let's see how it turned out. If it is quite nice, we can shade it. First I'll create a layer above this one, clip it and set it to multiply mode. Let's also change the colors. So if we go to color disk, we can replace this pink color with pink red. Let's draw at the lower part. Now we can merge these two layers and duplicate. Merge it again. Once it is ready, we can shape this big part of the head. So let's go here and create a layer between these two layers that will be clipped. Let's select dark pink color and also select textured shader. I will start drawing on this side first, adding this shadow, then also on the opposite side a little. After that I will switch to light pink. Draw on this edge to add the highlight and also here in the middle. Let's try to smudge these colors as well using textured shader. I will just make some strokes inside. Now the head is ready. We can merge all the layers for it and now shade the hair. So I will go to the layer number 2, which is the frontal part, and create a layer above it. Let's not forget to clip the layer and go to the color palette. Here I will first select light yellow orange, that is slightly darker than the base color. I will be using textured shader and set its size to around 21%. Let's start making strokes down. Trying to follow the shape of the hair at the bottom. After we did that, we can go even darker and select yellow-orange. I will lower the size to around 12% and start adding darker strokes for hair strands at some distance. Let's try to merge them with this hair shape at the bottom to create the volume. I will make a stroke here and then start drawing them under the head. Now that we added dark strands, let's also add some light ones. So we can switch to light yellow-grayish and start highlighting some parts. Not pressing too much on the pencil, just to get the texture. We can increase the size back again and continue drawing like this, highlighting the hair. We can add it here at the bottom as well. Then make the size very low, like 3% or 4%, and draw this hair. After we finish this part, we can go to the other one. It is layer number 3. I think we can just alpha lock the layer instead of creating a clipping mask. First select light yellow orange. Increase the size and start making the strokes here. Also on this part. Let's go even darker here as well and select yellow orange. I'll just make a couple of strokes. Here and also here. Now let's select light yellow grayish. Make the size low and start adding the highlights. I will make this tiny hairs and same on this part. Let's highlight the edge a little more. Now this part of the hair is finished. We can draw the sweater. Let's go ahead and merge some layers. Actually, we can merge all the layers for the hair here and maybe the entire head. Then create a new layer and place it below. As the base color for the sweater, I will be using cyan. Let's select it from the palette. And also pick textured liner. We can keep it very simple, according to the style. So I will first draw two arcs. One on the left side and another one on the right side for the very simple body shape. Let's connect these two lines on top part and also at the bottom. I will draw an arc here and then drag the color inside. Before we shade it, let's draw the sleeve. For that, let's create a new layer above this one and also lower the opacity of this part of the sweater, because we will use the same color. This will work. I will first draw two lines. This one may go very close to the hair, then connect them. It can be an arc. Now let's draw the elbow and go to the right. Here I will make it more rounded. And connect these two parts with a line. Now let's also fill this shape. And adjust if needed. just want to keep the edges textured. That's why I'm using this brush. I will continue working on the sleeve and add the knitting pattern on it. For that we need to create a new layer, right above the sleeve. Select grayish-green color from the palette and pick the pattern. I want to use hearts mini inverted. Then I will go to selection and divide the arm into two parts on the elbow. So let me first tap here and then on the opposite side, right under the elbow. After that I will outline the top part of the arm and tap to close the selection. Now I want to save the selection. For that we can pick Save and Load from this menu and then click on the plus icon. This selection will be saved. Now I will tap on the brush so we can use it and rotate the canvas to find the angle for the brush so we can apply the pattern. And this pattern is parallel to the sides. After that we can deselect. Let me clip this layer to the sleeve. And after that we need to paint the remaining part. So let's go to selection again and load the selection that we saved. For that we can click here and then pick the selection. After that we need to invert it and rotate the canvas as well to find the angle for this part. Let's tap on the brush and try to paint. I want to make the pattern parallel to these sides now. And it worked. After we deselect, we will get this. Now we can shade the sleeve. For that we can create a new layer between these two and it will be clipped right away. I will start with darker shades. So let's pick medium dark cyan color and also select textured shader from brushes. Here we can set the size to 25% and start applying the color at the lower part of the sleeve, not pressing too much on the pencil. Shade approximately half of it. After that I will change the color to dark cyan and shade the edge even more. Now let's add the highlight. And for that I will be using grayish blue green. I will first apply it here. Also applying low pressure. And then go to the right. Let's also add the color here on this part. Make the size lower and add the reflected light on the lower part, right on the edge. I'll try to blend the colors, applying low pressure, spread the color, and now I think it is ready. We can go back to this part of the sweater, bring back opacity and create a new layer above it. First we can add pattern here as well. So let's select grayish green and pick the pattern from the brushes. I will first draw around the sweater and make sure to cover it all. Then I will go to transformation and switch to warp. Let's make the pattern follow the shape on the sides. So it is more like curves. After that we can clip the layer and create another one between these two for shading. I will be using the same colors, so let's start from medium dark cyan and switch back to textured shader. I will set the size to 25% and start applying it here on the back and under the sleeve, also under the hair and on this part, not pressing too much. I will go even down and shade this part as well. After that, I will switch to dark cyan and add a darker shadow, starting from here under the hair and going along the edge on the back. Shade this area a little and also this part under the hair. Now let's add the highlights as well. For that we need to switch to grayish blue-green. With this color I will highlight the right side, here at the bottom, and also go along the edge this way, making vertical strokes. But I will make sure that the area under the sleeve is dark. We will get texture like this. Now I'd like to draw a simple hand. So let's select skin color. We can do it right from the head. And create a layer under all layers. I will select textured liner. And set its size to 7%. Let's outline a simple shape like this. It'll go a little upper here. Then I will make an arc and continue going down. Here it may go a little straight. Let's connect this part under the sweater and then drag the color. Let's shade it quickly as well, using orange color and alpha locking the layer. Let's select textured shader and darken the lower part. Also this area under the sleeve. With an angle. The color may go a little upper here. And I think this is enough. I think for the second sleeve we can group these layers. Then duplicate it and drag it down on the layers. Let's move it a little upper and rotate slightly, clockwise. We can add some extra shading on it quickly. So let's open the group and go to the layer with shading. I want to add some dark color. So let's pick medium dark cyan and textured shader. We can just darken the area here and also between these two sleeves to separate them from each other. Now that's better. We just need to draw the second hand. Now let's create a layer under the group. Pick skin color and textured liner. Just connect these two shapes with the line and paint this area. Then alpha lock the layer, pick orange color and add shading using textured shader brush. I'll just make a stroke between these two colors. Later we will add the flower here, between the hands. For now it is done. For the flower let's create a layer above this one and select yellow color. We will draw first two petals and place them very close to the head. Let's select textured liner and draw two shapes. One will go to the right side and the other one to the left. They may look completely different. Let's fill them and then create a layer below. I will select dark yellow now and draw another petal. Let's also fill it. Then create one more layer below and select light yellow grayish. That is the lightest color from yellows. To draw another petal in the gap between these two. It's just a random flower shape. You can totally go with your own. When it's done, let's shade the petals. I will keep this one as it is and go to the darkest one. I will alpha lock it and pick this light yellow color. Pick textured shader and just make a stroke on top. Then I will pick brown color from the eye and grainy shader. Here I will set the size to 7% and just make a stroke this way. Now let's shade these two petals. So I will alpha lock them and pick dark yellow. I will go back to textured shader and this time shade them at the bottom. This one as well. Now that we have the flower, we can draw the stem. For that I will pick cyan color, since it is very close to green. Let's select textured liner. We also need to create a layer under the petals, but above the hand. I think around 15% is fine. I'll start drawing from here and place the stem between the hands. We can also draw two small leaves on the sides and I will make them curvy this way. Then the other one. It may go a little lower. Now I will fill them both. Let me also shade them quickly using grayish blue green. I'll select grainy shader. Set it to 5%. Alpha lock the stem together with the leaves. And apply it here, on top. I think now we can work on the background. So I'll create a layer under all layers. And also we need to fix the hair. So I'll do this. I will merge all the layers for the flower. Tap on the layer and select it. If it selects something else, you will need to adjust the selection threshold by sliding to the right or to the left. We have the layer selected and I'm going to the head, opening the menu, and I will just click clear. This part of the hair will disappear. Let's proceed to the background. We have already this layer created, so let's go here and just fill it with dark purple color. We can also merge all the layers for the girl. And if it is too big, we can scale it just a tiny bit. Then create a layer above the background and under the girl. I will select dark brown from the palette and use textured shader. Let's set its size to around 46% and draw a circle under the girl. We can tap to make it perfect and scale it in this mode. Let's try to fill it and paint inside if needed. I will move the circle so it is more in the center. Now I'd like to crop the sweater at the bottom to match it with the edge of the circle. So we will be using the trick similar that we used here with the hair and the flower. First I will go to the circle and get it selected in the layers. I don't have color fill, and if it selects something else you will need to adjust the selection threshold by sliding your pencil. Now we need to invert the selection. Duplicate the layer with the girl and click clear in one of the layers. Now if we toggle the visibility of this one, we will see that it has been cropped. But I'd like to keep this fluffy part and also the flower. So I will go back to this layer where we have the sweater and either use a razor. Or we can also use selection, just outline this part and then clear. Now it is matching with the edge. Let's go to the layer with the circle and alpha lock it to apply textures. First I will select brown color and textured shader. Let's set the size to around 47 or 48% and start making circular strokes inside with very low pressure, just to add the subtle texture on it. Then I will switch to light brownish and pick harsh cracks from the brushes. It is in full size and opacity. I will just paint all over the circle. Now let's work on this dark area. So I'm going to the layer number 19, which is this dark one, creating another layer above it and switching to light grayish. Let's first apply star pattern. I will start drawing all over the canvas. And after that change the brush to subtle cracks textured. Also paint on it. Now the background is done. We only need to paint the remaining petals that are flying up in the air. For that I'll create a layer above all layers and start with this light yellow grayish. Let's select textured liner in the brushes and set the size to 15%. I will draw a small petal above this one. Let's fill it. And after that change the color to yellow to draw more petals. This time they will be bigger and they will also go in different directions. I will start from this side and create a shape like this. Still not too big. Let's fill it and then draw another one that will go more to the right. And it will cross the circle. I will also drag the color inside it and then continue to draw more. Let's create another petal that will be bigger outside the circle. I'm filling it and adjusting its shape so it looks more like a petal. I think we can draw another one. This time I will make it smaller. Or maybe we can even outline one of the existing petals. Then copy and paste it. Just change the angle and maybe scale it slightly. Alright, let's merge these two layers and alpha lock to shade it. I will switch to dark yellow color and textured shader. Let's keep it at around 16%. And add a few strokes on each petal for shading. I will draw on this one, then here, and the last one. Once we shade the petals, the illustration is ready. If you enjoyed this tutorial, please give it a like and don't forget to subscribe. You can also access more tutorials and brush sets on my Patreon. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.